Problem number two. A body weighing 4.9 kg is hung from a spring. A pull of 10 kg will stretch the spring to 5 centimeters. The body is pulled down 6 centimeters down below the static equilibrium position. Static equilibrium position and then released. Find the displacement of the body from its equilibrium position. Position at time t seconds. The maximum velocity and the period of oscillation. Oscillation. Now solution. First draw the diagram. Here a body weighing 4.9 kg is hung from a spring. And the strength of this spring is also given that a pull of 10 kg will stretch the spring to 5 centimeters. So a body weighing 4.9 kg from a spring is pulled down to 6 centimeters below the static equilibrium position and then released at time t equal to 0. So for this data, find the displacement of the body from its equilibrium position at time t seconds, also the maximum velocity and the period of oscillation. We have to find these three quantities from this data. Now first draw the diagram. In the given problem, a body weighing 4.9 kg is hung from a spring. So 4.9 kg hung from a spring which is in equilibrium position. We considered this as x is equal to 0. From this equilibrium position, it is pulled down to 6 centimeters at a time t equal to 0 and then released. In this case, find the displacement of the body from its equilibrium position at time t seconds, the maximum velocity and the period of oscillations. These three quantities we have to find. And also given the data to find the stiffness of the spring. How much this quantity the spring is stretching after body attached to the lower end of the spring. That is also given in the problem. From that data we have to find the spring constant. First here we fixed the one end of the spring at point O and A the lower end of the spring. Here we attached a body with weight 4.9 kg. In this equilibrium position we are assuming that x is equal to 0 from its equilibrium position. So in the downward direction the body is pulled down to 6 cm at time t equal to 0, and then we release. Therefore now write the steps. Let O be the fixed end and A the lower end of the spring. And let K be the spring constant or stiffness of the spring. To find the K value, here we have the data in the problem. A pull of 10 kg will stretch the spring to 5 cm. Write down. Given that a pull of 10 kg will stretch the spring to 5 cm. Therefore, by Hooke's law, spring force is equal to K into X. As in the previous problem, I clearly explained that no need to use sign minus or plus. F is equal to kx. Therefore here spring force is equal to weight 10 kg and x is equal to 5 cm. Stretch the spring to 5 cm, to a distance 5 cm. Therefore x is equal to 5 cm. F is equal to 10 kg force, spring force, k into x is equal to 5 cm. Therefore K is equal to 10 kg by 5 cm. That is equal to here we have to change this 5 cm into meters, because weight is given in the kg. Therefore it is comfortable to change the centimeters into meters. Therefore 10 kg equal to K into 5 by 100 meters, changing into meters. Therefore that is equal to 0.05 meters. Therefore K is equal to 10 by 0.05. therefore this is equal to 100,000, multiplying both numerator and denominator by 100 by 5. Therefore this is equal to 5 ones, 5 twos and zeros, 200. Therefore K is equal to 200 kg per meter. This is the stiffness of the spring or spring constant. Here, this is the Hooke's law. Now k is equal to 200 kg per meter. Now mass, we have to find the mass of the body. The mass of the body m is equal to formula weight by acceleration due to gravity. Therefore, this is equal to our body weight is 4.9 kg. Weight is hung from the lower end of the spring. Therefore, 4.9 kg by acceleration due to gravity, 9.8 meter per second square. Therefore, this is the mass. Since G is equal to formula 9.8 meters per second square. Now the equation of motion of spring mass system is, in case 1, in the free oscillations of a vertical spring, we proved that d square x by dt square plus mu square is into x equal to 0 is the equation of the free oscillations of the spring mass system, vertical spring mass system. Therefore, you remember this equation and you can directly write the equation of the motion of spring mass system in the free oscillations, d square x by dt square plus mu square x is equal to 0. Square x by dt square plus mu square into x is equal to 0, where mu square is equal to k by m, where mu square is equal to k by m. We proved in case 1, free oscillations. Say this is equation number 1. Now find mu square. Mu square is equal to k value. We already proved that 200 kg per meter. 200 by m, we proved that 4.9 kg by 9.8 meters per second square. Therefore, this can be written as 200 into 9.8 by 4.9. So, if you can multiply both numerator and denominator by 10, we get 98 by 49. Therefore, 49 ones, 49 twos. Therefore, this is equal to 400. Mu square is equal to 400. This is the mu square value. Therefore, equation 1 becomes d square x by dt square plus 400 into x is equal to 0. Here put d by dt is equal to capital D. Then above equation becomes capital D square plus 400, d square into x, 400 into x. So this can be written as d square plus 400 into x is equal to 0. This is ordinary differential equation with constant coefficients. Right hand side is 0. Therefore, complementary function gives the complete solution. To find the complementary function, first we have to write auxiliary equation. Auxiliary equation is d square plus 400 is equal to 0. Therefore, d square is equal to minus 400. As in the previous problems, we can write I square into 400. Since I square is equal to minus 1, therefore d is equal to plus or minus I into 20. Here alpha value 0, beta value 20. Roots are imaginary. Therefore, the solution of equation 1 is x is equal to c e to the power of alpha into t, but alpha value 0, e power 0 t equal to 1. So therefore c1 cos beta value 20 t plus c2 sin beta t, beta value 20. Therefore x is equal to c1 cos 20 plus c2 sin 20. Say this is equation number 2. Initially, when time t equal to 0, so from x is equal to 0, the body is pulled down to 6 centimeters. Therefore, at time t equal to 0, initial displacement x is equal to 6 centimeters. And the velocity dx by dt is equal to 0. We use these two initial conditions to find the arbitrary constant c1 and c2 in the solution. That means in the equation number 2. Initially, when time t equal to 0, the displacement x equal to 0. Substituting these values in equation 2, we get x value 0. In the left hand side, we are substituting the right hand side c1 cos 20 into t value 0, cos 0, 1 plus c2 into sin 20 into t value 0, sin of 0, 0. Therefore, c1 into 1 plus c2 into 0. Therefore, c1 is equal to 0. Substituting c1 in equation number 2, the value of c1 in equation 2, we get x is equal to c1 cos 20, c1 value, sorry, in the initial displacement is 6 centimeters. He has given 6 centimeters, so not 0, 6 centimeters. Therefore, in meters, 6/100, 0.06 meters. Therefore, this value, x value, is equal to, here we have to substitute 0.06. Therefore, C1 value 0.06. Therefore, x is equal to C1 value 0.06 into cos 20t plus C2 into sin 20t. Say this is equation number 3. Now another condition, initial velocity dx by dt. For this we have to differentiate equation 3. Now dx by dt, differentiating equation 3 with respect to t. Therefore dx by dt is equal to 0.06 derivative of cos minus sine 20t into derivative of 20t, that is 20, plus C2 into derivative of sine cos 20t into derivative of 20t is equal to 20. Therefore, this is a dx by dt. Initially, when time t equal to 0, initial velocity dx by dt is also 0. Substituting these values in the above equation. Therefore, dx by dt value 0. Is equal to sine of 0, t equal to 0, sine 0, 0, plus 20 C2 into cos of 20 into 0, cos 0, cos 0 value 1. Therefore, 20 C2 equal to 0. Therefore, C2 value equal to 0. Therefore, C2 is equal to 0. Substituting C2 in equation number 3. Substituting C2 in equation number 3. Equation 3 is x is equal to 0.06 cos 20t plus C2 sin 20t. Since C2 equal to 0, this equation becomes x equal to 0.06 cos 20t. Substituting the value of C2 in equation 3, we get x is equal to 0.06 into cos 20t. Displacement of the body from its equilibrium position at any time t greater than 0. This is one part of the question, and another two parts we have to find. One is maximum velocity and another one is amplitude. period. Displacement of the body from its equilibrium position at a time t seconds. This solution is over. Next, the maximum velocity and the period of oscillation. Now, maximum velocity. Is equal to formula mu into amplitude. Therefore, mu value we already calculated. Mu square is equal to 400. Therefore, mu is equal to 20 square root of mu. Mu square is equal to 400. Therefore, mu is equal to 20. 20 into amplitude, maximum displacement. So at a time t equal to 0, we pulled the body up to 6 centimeters. Therefore, that is the maximum displacement. Therefore, amplitude is equal to 0.06 meters. Therefore, this is equal to 20 into 0.06, that is equal to 1.2 meters per second. This is the maximum velocity. Next, another is period of oscillations. Another one is the period of oscillation. Capital T is equal to formula 2 pi by mu. That is equal to 2 pi by mu value 20, that is equal to 10 pi by 10, 22 by 70, since pi is equal to 22 by 7 into 10, 22 by 7, 0.314 seconds. T is equal to 0.314 seconds. This ends the problem solution.